I have to do that.
I didn't bring the banner to show some similarities too. Go for it. Go for the banner.
Yeah,
whatever we
so the bishop will take a
picture.
I like the way you're so excited.
Come, let us take a picture. You don't have to bring the picture. Come on.
What's your mug?
Junior Sec.
Okay.
And then he came to Shantimela as principal, and due to sickness he retired in 2002.
Okay.
And I took over the principalship from him.
Okay.
But he was my very, very, very good friend. Humble, most humblest man I ever met. He was generous. He was everything. Surely we'll miss him. Surely we'll miss him. A little brother, and this is the present principal.
Okay, okay.
I am retired too, and she's there now.
He was the closest one to us.
Yeah,
he has to get the rest of them. Yes, you know, that's Gerson was the one that had a connection of Yes, they went on a trip and the bus went to the
accident in April.
About maybe 6 or 8 died in this village.
Yeah.
And let's get some broken ribs.
Broken ribs and so on.
And
yeah,
he stayed with us till he got better and he came back up. Yeah.
I'm not here anymore.
I'm not here anymore. Riding planes. And he come down the hill instead of taking the corner, he goes straight to the hill. One of them both was.
Okay.
Yeah. And a lot of them get killed. Okay. You have to go for it on the side.
Yes, folks, we now we are on the way to the RC church. So stay tuned. We'll try to maintain the live until we reach in the church. We get some history about Mr. Ferguson on our way up.
standing still.
So continuing the live, so you could, okay, you could tell people something about him while we
undergo.
Yeah.
Oh yes, so we live in the school where Mr. Ferguson taught since 1970. He was such a loving, humble, generous man. For all the years we worked together, he was a true friend. And as old people say, sometimes he used to take his death like sheep. He give up his right for peace. That's how peaceful he was. I know he will be missed. Pray ask God to keep me strong today, so I won't cry.
So how long he was principal for since?
39 years.
39 years, okay.
Yes, yes.
And then he hand over the baton to you?
To me, yes.
And how long you were principal for?
From 2002 to 2016. Yes.
14 years?
Teaching there all my life together with him, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, so I've been teaching there after he left because he was sick and then he was advised to take early retirement.
Okay.
Yes. These people were afraid, you know, he was going to go since then, but he persevered and God kept him. He rallied through until that fateful March 13th, that memorable day. It's a day we won't forget. When we remember March 13th, we will also remember Mr. Ferguson, the day he departed.
Okay.
Yes. He lived across there. Okay. Inside there, yes. And I know Kels and Jenna will miss him a lot. And Yuri and Omari, his two grandsons who were there with him, he loved them dearly and they loved him dearly too. His loving daughter, Desna. She was the first. She is the first. And I know it will be very painful. She's in the States and she can't be here now. Wow. I know it will be very, very painful for Desna today. Very, very painful. Very painful. And their mom, Ivis, she too is in the States. So they cannot make it. So it will be tough. It will be hard for them. Jenna is trying to keep up because she's the one here, both herself and Kels. But we will be there with them. Make sure that everything is alright. I know it will be hard for them. They will miss him a lot. Because he was always at home from his sickness.
Okay.
Yes, he was always at home. So wherever they went, when they came back, he was there. So when you have someone like that at home, you know, they will surely be missed. They will surely be missed. Yes, we've been sad ups and downs, good times and bad times. Mr. Ferguson there. Whatever activities teachers have, his partner, Rupert George, who went before him, he was the one who, whenever there is an activity, he will say, well, we used to call him Foggy. Say, well, Foggy, go in and that, you know, and then he might pass and meet me, and we went, you know. But after Mr. George died, well, he more or less started staying home because he didn't really feel comfortable going out, you know.
Okay.
And Mr. George had a transport, so he used to go right there. He always kept abreast with what was going on. And he was an avid sports person. Years he was the president of the St. Patrick's Sports Council. Chantimel, so there's all the villages around. He was the president of that sports council.
Okay.
And then later he became president of the Chantimel Sports Club and the manager of the football team. He did that for all the years. And anything you wanted to know about sports, you just had to ask Foggy and you would get that information. He was so into sports. Very much a sportsman. But sometimes we used to tell him if he used to run in the years. He went to McDonald College. He was one of the early students at McDonald College. Maybe first or second batch since the school opened. Yes, so he was a college man, MDC man. From there
there. He went to Grand Rye Government School. Mm-hmm. Yes, he taught down there for some time. When he even taught, when the revolution came about, he taught in Waltham Junior Sec for 9 months.
Okay.
And when the revolution collapsed, then he came back to Chantimel as principal.
Okay.
Yes. So he was there, he went, and then he came back in 1884. After the revolution collapsed. But he just had a very short stint at St. Max Secondary.
Okay.
And he was also a real Catholic man.
Oh.
Yes. He was president of church council.
Okay.
Yes, he was president of our church council. He was the finance man, the trustee, the treasurer.
Okay.
Yes, and he was also president of the Men's League at Chantimel. So he was all round. He was an all rounder. And people respected him. Whatever everybody will go to, Mr. Respect. Some people. And take it cool. He was that person. He was that person. There were children, you know, sometimes children so rude and so. When they left school, then they came to him to write a reference, and he would say, Miss Philip, I don't think I could write it, you know. Yes, he still felt, you know, obligated to do it. He was quiet and he loved people. To help. Wait, it would be a sad day. It would be a sad day. So we're counting only 7 persons who taught with him as principal.
Okay.
Are still in Grenada. Well, some passed, some traveled. But 7 of us who remain, well, we'll be doing a tribute in the church.
Okay.
Yes. We're hoping that we'd have more children lying in the street, but we're school going on holidays there. Some of them would just dress and come down to the funeral.
Okay.
Yes.
Back in Mali?
No, Mali.
Okay.
Nobody yet to help to put off that.
Yes, folks, so there you had it. You had some history about Mr. Fuggy.
Do you need any help?
Nah, good.
Good. Alright,
yeah.
Thanks.
Alright.
Right now.
Ferguson, aka Kesta and Reid, 87th Street, former principal of Shantymel RC School.
Thank you.
wait for some help, but nobody's ever been here.
Yeah, he was a very great principal, George Ferguson. Former principal of the Shanty Mel Government School. So we are delayed by the rain, and also we need manpower to take the casket out of the hearse.
Excuse me. You want somebody to help you with the body?
Yeah, we want somebody, but we don't want.
Well, you go check for me.
Yeah.
Well, I'm waiting to.
When you were. Yeah,
I'm waiting,
man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I was going to ask.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, honey, you must be the girl.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, church. The persons on the outside, please come in so we can begin the tributes.
distributed from the Chantemel RC School. As we are aware, Mr. Ferguson was our dear past principal, and so the school would pay tribute in an acrostic poem.
Will now have one of his best buddies,
old schoolmate, past principal of McDonald College, no other person than Chief Mr. James Alexander, to do his tribute.
One and all, but especially to the family of George Ferguson. It was Mark Anthony speaking Caesar's funeral. He said, "My heart is in public, very secret, and thoughts till it comes back to me." The same is true of my good friend, Reid. Do not cry as those who have no hope. Let us believe sincerely that we lived a good life. And if we set the trail, we are going to be out behind you following. For as the Bible says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes to you. Knowing full well that if we live and we emulate the example that he left us, one day we will see him. And those of us who believe in the Christian faith, he said death is just asleep. So he's sleeping and looking forward to be reacquainted with him on that great judgment. He was also a very good person in Spanish. So I'm going to leave this little one. Adios.
Thank you, Chief. We'll now have a song by Sister Harissa Batiste on behalf of Avina Frey, the dear and beloved niece of Fogo. He was her dada. She loved him dearly. So now Harissa will come and give a tribute on behalf of Avina.
Good afternoon. An empty street, an empty house, a hole inside my heart. I'm all alone, the rooms are getting smaller. I wonder why they are. The days we had, the sun.
Some
He was an ardent believer of the Catholic faith. He served as president of the Men's League at Chantanel, Holy Spirit Catholic Church, and also president of the church council, treasurer. He was always there. He attended Mass every Sunday religiously, and every other church activity, be it Harvest, whatever it was, you can count on Mr. Ferguson. After his passing, or since he became sick, we started missing him every Good Friday, because he was our Peter, one of the few men in the church. Now our Peter has gone, our pilot has gone. The two brothers, Mr. George Ferguson and Mr. Rupert George, I know they will be happy together, friends forever. I now call on the Holy Spirit Irish Church Choir to do the tribute.
Inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to play.
one of his grand nieces to do a poem. Okay. And now call on the staff who had been with Mr. Ferguson from day one. Well, he began his teaching career at the Grand Rye Government School in 1968. And was later transferred to Chantinel RC School in 1970. However, with the entrance of the revolution and the opening of the junior secondary schools, he was then transferred to the Walton Junior Secondary School in 1983 for only 9 months. Then back to Chantinel he came in 1984. Now the teachers who taught with him, please come so you can do your tribute. I taught with him from 1976 until the time he went home. So you know the closeness we had. We became family.
Pilgrims on the journey of the narrow road. underline that listen to the road beat must run. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we live lead them to believe, and the lies we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful.
once we did.
Thank you.
about a thing.
Worry about a thing.
Cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Singing, don't worry about a thing. To you, and say don't worry about a thing. Don't worry about a thing, cause everything is gonna be alright. Sing it, don't worry about a thing. Don't worry about a thing now, every little thing is gonna be alright. Yeah. Rise up this morning. Smile with the rising sun. Treat a little bird. Reach by my doorstep. Singing sweet songs. A melody's pure and true. Sing. This is my message.
You can sing along with us if you want to. Sing with me.
Sing. Don't worry about a thing. Don't worry about a thing.
Our beloved brother George Ferguson.
Thank you very much. The thing is, I was told that I never thought about this, but I can just call this one season in front of me. The parliamentary report of Congress, former Prime Minister from Thomas, also my friend, Victor Fisher, who is my other friend as well. And I think maybe the reason why I'm starting this union, I guess that's the way for me, for the extended permission that I got paid. But anyway, I like to give you good news. Sometimes you say things that you love to say, and sometimes you say things that you have to say. And this is a quote from Mr. Jesus. And this will be falls into that category of something that I have to say, or maybe probably in keeping with the name Reid, it is something that I have to read. Most times,
including Jim Alexander, Dr. Keller.
continue along the level of fairness. And I never did it at the same level of him. Didn't get special treatment either. You know, didn't get special treatment. Truth be told, I never knew how he didn't get special treatment this morning. And even though she felt she did not enjoy it, probably I still didn't get that. But most interesting was an incident I remember with my dad. Also got that issue. And said to me, when I woke up, okay. And then I asked him, I said, who are you? And then it dawned on me that the same person gave me the truth, but the same person was the wrong way. Right, the next part was supposed to be the achievement in sports, so that was done already. So I'll just move on there. George Ferguson was someone who loved the community and saw a good in it. And I was telling that there was an issue for those who were making an effort to build the village. He was always willing to help another who sought his assistance. So he was not only fair, he was selfless and extremely generous, maybe even too generous for his own ideas. He supported many persons financially and never mentioned anything about it. In fact, it was up until his passing that I never knew. God knew many of the persons he would have helped when they would have called to offer their thanks for the assistance that he would have rendered to them. Even if at times he was rested, came for his assistance, he would go out to meet them, despite Jenna Kelton and Harry begging not to do so. They got fed up at times, especially Jenna, and she asked, I really despise your love. But that was the kind of person he was. He wanted to make sure that whatever he did it with passion and he did it with generosity. It is also worth mentioning that at our time, he was battling cancer. And yet he had passed the service to his parents, who was in the prominent in his exams. That's the passion he had in his self-pity was not the word he used to carry. And he never wanted to be from anyone. Whenever Jenna would ask him, okay, he would simply reply, everything is all right, that his eyes are closed in a little trouble, I'm okay. Even his last words of Jenna were, Jenna would worry. And I guess it was appropriate since his theory that was one man involved echo to see his essence. He was an avid church member and a member of the Catholic magazine. He was also a part of the church advocacy group, not only planning and working in the Catholic itself, and also the parish as well. He would work from the time the parish started to the time the last church left, despite all the pain he was enduring. Going back to his time as principal, he not only had to battle with cancer, but he had to battle with some education officials. One of whom might be cancer from personal age, and I didn't get it. I would not assume the reason for saying it. So, when it was time for appraisal, and he was given no grade by the education officer, meaning that he did not receive increasing salaries. Right? Because he felt that what he was doing, he was doing it the best. Upon his retirement, he became a king in cancer. This showed a lot of quality, determination. Sadly, it was a case for many of us, or many good people, I should say. After one battle seemed to come another, this time he had a battle with diabetes. But despite that, he still continued to assist in the community, especially since he was an expert on mathematics. I guess we can also specify that. Now, this is where I will just like that for a few minutes, just get ready. During that time when he had been silent, many claim of wonderful words and how he had impacted their lives, but only he visited it. Like it or not, and I say this in one part, this is typical of that. We always have a problem of not supporting us, and we still do. We love to add our lives. Or those who have high ambition for the other race. This actually made me avoid it as much as possible, because I would have brought up that issue with him, but I knew he would not want to hear about it. So we communicated mainly via phone, discussing various issues, partly in this course. He was a living testimony of wanting Chantel to be a better place, and wanting others to support who live and live in Chantel. I firmly believe that this is where my sense of selflessness and And I guess that's the only point. When you continue to dedicate yourself to his education, as an expert, as an expert, to become a doctor. Or each time that you go for the lessons, or whether it's just being a moment, so there's no making sacrifices, or to care for the work of sports in the community, or business standards. This legacy would live on. But outside of the family, where does the memory lie with others? And I'm referring specifically to us here. Many times when someone dies, we often use the word rest in peace and never forget. And I always ask myself, why are we lying to us? Because many times, by the time a funeral service is over, maybe 50% of us forget who that was. If you want to prove me wrong, this is what I just said about. You can ensure that the memory and legacy of God Ferguson lives on by supporting those in the community who are destined to make a difference to ensure we have a better chance. Like it's a great feeling, Mr. Joseph Arnold and Luca, Patrice, and the other young men who are trying to get back to the ball. Give them your support. Life is short, and we don't know when these community members will be back. But we are still here. Those who are trying to reach out to the place, let's support them. This is how we can honor the memory and legacy of George Kessler and Ferguson. If we are not willing to do so, then please go see our little project. Let us see. Thank you.
Let us all stand and begin in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, and the dominion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I bless the body of George with the holy water that repours his baptism for which Saint Paul writes, all of us were baptized into Jesus Christ, were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him. So that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness of his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, George put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with glory. And and let us sing the entrance.
Refreshment in life. Let him pass on hand through the gates of death to dwell with the blessed in light, as you promised to Abraham and his children forever. Ascend joy into your safe kingdom, and on the judgment, great day of judgment, raise him up with all his saints to inherit your eternal kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you. Thank you.
from the song. A lot of things is clear. Whether we write or not, whether we talk about it or we don't talk about it, we are all going to die someday. That is a reality. Whether we fear to talk about it or not, it doesn't matter your age. It doesn't matter where you are born. It doesn't matter the kind of how you cry. It doesn't matter the size of your house. The end of all flesh is death. When we gather like this, an occasion like this, we have to reflect on our own lives. That someday, we must go. The death of someone is a reminder to all of us. No longer is there. No matter how tough you are, no matter how strong you think you are, we all go one day. And as the Bible said, it's a matter of men and women to die once. But after death is judgment. The matter of death is not surprising to God. Death is not surprising to God because God knows exactly when each and everyone here will die. It is surprising to us. Because you don't know when you will depart from this heavenly life. And that's why sometimes we write quite a shock. It's a shocking to us. But it is not shocking to God. You talk to someone in a few days' time, 2 days' time, few hours' time, and tomorrow comes, you will hear that person is gone. And that is how a human mind is. Death is inevitable. Tomorrow may not come. Many people have died in their sleep. They were about to sleep and there was no chance of any sickness. But they didn't wake up from the sleep. Some people died to play in the crush. And they died in Sunday. Some people have died from accidents. But they were living in a house. They told that they had children in the house. They told their wives and their husbands. They were going to come. And never returned home. Some people just collapsed. And others, their lives were cut short by some mentally deranged people. So the reality is that a child will come. We will come to the end of our lives. As we read the gospel, Jesus Christ, after his earthly life and mission here on earth, ministry to people, healing and teaching, his life came to an end. His earthly journey came to an end. And so this morning we have the beauty I see, the beauty with all the power, with all the makeups, for one day return to dust. We are from dust and one day we shall return to dust. We have to remind ourselves, especially in our occasion like this, that this beautiful body we have, shining brightly, adorned with gold, for one day return to dust. And our spirit will
return to God, and the soul and the spirit will go to the eternal location. And if you are Christian, you are saved. Then the eternal location will be in heaven. If you are not saved, the eternal location is a place you didn't want to go. So when a person dies on this earth, he closes his eyes on this earth and he opens his eyes in the next life in the presence of God. And when one dies, nothing can be done for the eternal destiny up. Nothing can be done for our eternal destiny. So if there is anything you want to do, you have to do it now. If there is somebody you want to reconcile with, you have to do it now. If there is somebody you want to forgive, it is now. Because tomorrow is not promised. If there is anybody you want to show kindness or generosity, it is now. Because when we die, because after death, we cannot reconcile with that person again. After death, we cannot forgive again. But there is hope for us Christians. The hope is that, and the hope is that after death, there will be resurrection. There will be resurrection for us in Christ. There is life beyond death. So even though we are mourning and crying and weeping, we are mourning and are weeping with God. Because there is a sinner life. There is resurrection. It is not the end of the believer. Death is not the end of the believer. We don't live our life as if everything ends here. Everything does not end here. For us Christians, for us believers, death is not the end. And that's why we didn't know after death, even though after death is a focus, that death in Christ will rise. Beyond death, there is resurrection. One day the dead will come.
And that's why you will be forever missed by the community. Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted unto the Lord, the Almighty Father.
If the Lord accepts the sacrifice and the hands,
let us pray, God of loving kindness, listen liberally to our prayers. Listen, strengthen our belief that your Son Jesus Christ has risen. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial
as worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that God take up the body and blood of Christ, may be regarded into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of church, together with Francis, our Pope, Pius, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember yourself.
Thank you.
Before we go our seven ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
folks, you can go ahead and like the page because we resume the live by the cemetery. Go ahead and like the page, so we'll resume when we read by the cemetery. Stop and restart the live at the Reid by the cemetery, so you can like the page and subscribe to the channel, so once we go live you'll get a notification. In a couple of minutes we will start a new live by the cemetery, folks, so like the page so you'll get a notification. We are on our way to Mali Cemetery now.